Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. This week I'm going to show you how to add mist and fog to your photographs. Let's start off with some mist. I'd like some mist rising up from the lake here. To add the mist in, I'm actually going to use layers. So if you can't see your layers, go to Window and choose Layers. I'm going to put the mist on its own separate layer. So I'm going to click the new layer icon, which is down here, thing that looks like a folded piece of paper. Click that and you'll get a new empty layer. Now let's get the paintbrush and I'm going to set my foreground colour to white because that's the misty colour, and then using a nice big soft brush I'm just going to paint along the lower part of the picture where the lake is, just to give that feeling of mist, except it's rather a bit too heavy, it's more like snow than mist. So to soften it down, to make it more translucent, I'm going to come back to my layers and just drop the opacity of that new layer down, that's the layer with the mist on, to around about 50% or thereabouts, and that should give a nice sort of semi-transparent look. Okay, so that's mist, but fog is a little bit thicker. It tends to have a little bit more form and shape to it. So let's add some fog in. Now for fog, I'm actually going to use a second photograph, but not a picture of fog. No, I'm going to use a picture of clouds. Now I reckon anyone anywhere in the world could probably take a picture just like this. So I find these really good to use. Now you could use the clouds filter inside of Photoshop if you like, but I like to use photographs of real clouds. It has a much more organic, much more natural look. Now I don't want coloured clouds, I want black and white ones. So let's come up to Image, Adjustments and Desaturate. And I've got to get this sky to be black and white. I need these areas that were blue to be really dark black. So I'm going to come back to Image, Adjustments and Levels. Now on my histogram here you can see I've got nothing at all at the black end and not much at the light end either. So I'm just going to get the black slider and just drag this in. As I do, you can see these darker areas now going really, really black, really blocking up. Let's go a little bit further. I'm also going to bring in the light areas as well so I get a nice high degree of contrast in my clouds. You can just move the mid-tones a bit if you like, just to give it a bit of a tweak and a feather. Click OK and you've now got some really heavy black and white clouds. Now that's perfect for making fog. Let's add that into our original picture. We'll just get the Move tool and drag our newly converted sky layer on like so, and we'll close down the original because we don't need it anymore. Great! Now where's the picture? Well, it's underneath, so it's still there, it's still safe. But to be able to see through this clouds, these black and white clouds, I'm going to come back to Layers. Now you'll find you have a new layer now, which is where you've just dragged on the clouds. And I'm going to change the blend mode from Normal to Screen. Now Screen has the effect that it makes anything black completely transparent, anything grey semi-transparent, and so on. Now straight away you can see that has a sort of foggy effect, but it's way up in the air here and I want it just to be hanging over the lake. So I'm going to squash this down using Edit and Free Transform. I'm just going to grab one of the corner handles or the middle handles here and just squash and resize this until it's about the sort of shape that fits in neatly over the area of the lake, like so. Around about there looks good to me. And we'll double click inside or click the tick just to make that change permanent. So I've squashed my fog down, but it still doesn't look quite right. It's a bit too sharp and fog is much softer. It's much more fluffy. It's not quite so hard and angular. So let's soften it down by going to Filter, Blur and Gaussian Blur. Now how much Gaussian Blur should you put in here? Well, probably quite a bit, I think. So let's go up to around about the 30 mark, somewhere around about there like so. And that softens down those hard edges and gives some nice gentle undulating fog. If you've still got hard edges, you can go around with the eraser tool, a nice soft brush, and just erase bits away, just to making sure that you don't have any hard-edged lines in there. It's a bit heavy, so I'm going to come back to my layers and just drop the opacity of that foggy layer down. Again, just like we did with the mist, just to give it a bit of translucency. Now that's quite nice, and you could quite happily stop there. But if you want to give the fog a little bit more texture, you can make a copy of that layer by dragging it down to the new layer icon and letting go. You can come up to Edit, Transform and flip it horizontally. So that'll turn it the other way around. We're trying to avoid a repeating pattern coming here. And if you really want to give it a different look, go back to Edit and Free Transform, and maybe move it and stretch it and just reshape it, perhaps even put a little bit of a twist in it as well, just to get the feeling of fog rolling through the picture, like so. You can always come back to your layers and tweak your opacity and changes and bits and pieces in here just to get the effect to look exactly how you want it to go. I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, so there we go. We now have a lovely kind of fog and mist rising up from the lake. So we've gone from an ordinary picture like that to one that's got a fair bit of fog and mist.